Everyone, this is Jim from CitiBike Walk East. Hope you're having a great day. Today is November the 3rd, 2020. And I'm here at the plaza, right off of on Fifth Avenue. And today I'll be walking down Fifth Avenue, going south, and then checking out the Rockefeller Center. Here's the Plaza Hotel. You see there's a lot of scaffolding. And I also notice, if you notice, there's also some boarding, some plywood boarding on the windows. So today is election day, so we'll find out what will happen tomorrow. If anything, hopefully there won't be any civil unrest. Yeah, let's get started. There's a beautiful fountain. Right across the street is the Apple Store. And I just began my shot with the southeast porch corner of Central Park. So I walk. The Apple Store in the distance. I'm just gonna head south. See, there's a lot of security at the Apple Store. They just released the iPhone 12. Looks like. Fifth Avenue features a lot of luxury brands, luxury department stores. Across the street is Beardoff Goodman. I noticed they're boarded up as well. Boarding here. I also have a store across the street. A lot of police presence. This is Louis Vuitton. Cleaning up. This is 57th Street, also known as Billionaire's Row. This street is closed off. There's a shot of, I believe that's 111 West 57th Street. Looks like it's still under construction. Okay. Street is blocked off. Over here is Tiffany. They're under renovation. well known for their sky blue, a baby blue color scheme. Well, we can't see past beyond the police trucks, but this is Trump Tower. I believe there's supposed to be a Black Lives Matter paint on the street. I'm not sure if that's still there. These police trucks are completely surrounded. Trump Tower. A lot of media presence here, which is to be expected. Let's see if we get a better shot. We got Armani, Dolce & Gabbana. You see some media presence. Are covering the news. This is Harry Winston. I'm beginning to see a lot more stores boarded up in anticipation of the election results. Peninsula Hotel. This very famous hotel here. They have a really nice rooftop bar. Unfortunately, might not be able to go there right now, but yeah, it's very beautiful inside. This is the Fifth Avenue Presbyterian Church. Even the trees are bagged up, protected. More stores boarded up. I'm hoping nothing will happen. But we certainly can't count on that. Because of the result of the George Floyd protests back in early June. This area was hit pretty bad. With a lot of looting and destruction of property. I believe this is MoMA. Be wrong. This is the Microsoft store across the street. They're boarded up. And this is this is St. Thomas Church. Very beautiful. Across the street on that corner. This is Uniworld. They're boarding up in anticipation. Precaution, depending on how you look at it. It's a Salvatore Ferragamo. It's a Zara store. They're not boarded up, open for business. That's the Nike store on Fifth Avenue. This Cartier across the street, Versace, Longchamp, A. Stern. This is Victoria's Secrets. Across the street is the very famous, world famous St. Patrick's Church. A cathedral, I should say. Very beautiful. And right across the street is Rockefeller Center. You see, as you can see, they continue to board up. look down 50th Street. And across the street will be Rockefeller Center. And that right there is Saks Fifth Avenue with their world famous Christmas window dressing. Unfortunately, that's all boarded up right now. We'll see what happens when the holidays come around and see if that opens up. We can see some Christmas displays and maybe they'll get in the holiday mood. But for now, it's boarded up. If I could walk through the promenade to get to the Rockefeller Center. Wow, I've never been able to walk here or through here without a crowd of people. So with all the tourists, they're gone. But looks like they still have their, well, it's been dressed up with autumn decorations with the pumpkins and plants. Looks really nice. There's Tiffany. It's actually a Lego store here. That's been boarded up. And I've got to keep some Lego pieces away from certain people. They'll do anything to get these Legos. Here we have Rockefeller Center. I think that's where you go to get to the top of the rock observatory. That's when winter comes around. That's the ice rink. Let's see if normally all these American flags would be, would have the flag from every country, and now it's election day, it's all decorated with the American flag. So very nice. There's a reverse shot to the promenade. We'll walk around a little bit and then come back to Fifth Avenue. course, this is 30 Rock is home of NBC Studios. There's a lone man in the middle of the rink cleaning up. Just empty here. That's the entrance to 30 Rock Comcast building. A shot of this beautiful, almost like Art Deco style artwork. Down that direction towards 6th Avenue is Radio City Music Hall. A lot of live performances there. There's a shot of 50th Street. And just made a circle over on 5th Avenue, came through the promenade and then circle around here. All right, I'll make my way back to 5th Avenue. Snap a picture. Might not be a good idea to walk that direction. Let's see a lot. There's a crew painting up the plywood boards. Alright, so we're back on 5th Avenue. H&M out across the street. The Philippines consulate. Looks like they're boarding up. The Philippines Center. Thank you. that's the NBA store. And there's a Best Buy across the street. And I'm approaching 42nd Street. And I'm right across the street is the New York Public Library. And behind that is Bryant Park, over in this direction. Yesterday I made a video about the One Vanderbilt building, which is this building right here, so feel free to check it out. So I'll end this video with a shot of the New York Public Library. I'll walk a little bit closer towards it and you can see it better. I believe the main reading room, it's been under renovation, so I'm not sure if they completed it, but it'd be nice to check it out, see what's going on. New York Public Library with you've seen Ghostbusters. It's a very famous scene that was filmed in here. Alright, so that'll do it for this video. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope we have a very good outcome from the election and there's no civil unrest. And I'll see you on the next one. All right, bye.